Use headphones for best experience. Thanks for your fantastic. I should definitely do it now, so that's why I will do this today. And Essos is a really large continent, lot of different areas. Let's see if I can get room for everything here. This piece of paper, it's a black paper that I have prepared with some ink, some white ink first, and then some blue and green ink. But if this is the center, I think we should place the main content. Need some room here for the summer sea. And this won't be the entire continent of Essos, because no one has ever seen a map of the entire continent, I guess. It's undiscovered, the eastern part of it. Because it's so vast, so it will be just the part of it that I've seen on maps. Big island to the north, Ib. Larger island here to the south, Great Morak. Then we have a totally different continent here, also very unexplored. It's the Satheros. Divides Essos in the western part and the eastern part, making the eastern part even more mysterious. What's east of these mountains? Not many now. These are the Bone Mountains. The most known part of this continent is, maybe not as a surprise, it's the west closest to Westeros, because I guess this world is seen mostly from Westeros. And here we have a bay called Slaver. To do this as accurate as possible. This is like very light sketching, so I won't do any major mistakes while drawing the coastline. Valyria, really interesting area of this continent. Also have some islands here, the Summer Islands. Three major islands. Island here. Think, will this be enough? Preparation, perhaps. Stepstones. How are you? Was possible in the history to walk by foot to Westeros before those were destroyed. Before that land bridge was destroyed and turned into these stepstones. Okay. Now I think I'm ready for the outlines of the coast. So let's start in the northwest corner, the city of Braavos. Tyros, the disputed lands. Volantis. What's left? Sea here called the Sea of Sighs. Port city of Tholos. The Slaver's Bay and the this peninsula here with the old empire of Kis. Straits of Kart. To move this island, Great Morak, a bit to the east. So it does make sense. Port Morak. An ancient empire, another one that was located here. It was the Golden Empire of Yi Ti. Mysterious. Don't know much about these places here called the Shadowlands and mysterious city of Ashai. Here actually we have another continent starting here, Ultos, that we don't know much about at all. More than its name. Here we have Leng. It's quite a big island. So that's basically the southern coast of Vessus. Again. Now it's important to have like peninsulas to the north to see that it matches the shape of the coast to the south. I have a reference map here that I'm looking at. So I want it to be right. Maybe I can start here instead. Umber. And north of the Valyrian Peninsula we have Morosh. And the Bitterweed Bay. North of Kohor. It's a lot of archipelago and islands. Canada, a lot of islands, one quite big island here, where I believe the old capital of Valyria was located. Smoking Sea. Heard somewhere that this watch could be boiling still. Hundreds of years after the volcanoes erupted here. There's a small island called the Isle of Cedars. The New Keys and Kyle, located here, Kyle and New Keys. So let's move to the east. Now we have mysterious kingdom of Ifekebron. Ifekebron, really. Pronounce his name. And the Yoguin, north of the Bone Mountains. Here we have a peninsula. The Leviathan Sound, or the Leviathan Sound. This mysterious, remember we're east of the Bone Mountains now, this super mysterious, the Thousand Islands. It's a big archipelago here, lots of small islands. But I guess it's not thousands of them. Maybe 300 or something like that. I think I have to move the whole map a bit down because we have a big island here called Ib. We won't be able to see all of it, but maybe the south coast. And there is a lot of small islands. Here, like an archipelago where the Ibn lives, where they live, and here's Far Ib, another island a bit to the east. And then we have some islands to the south, not just islands, but also a whole continent. We have Lesser Morak. So if you go from Great Morak to Lesser Morak, it's not so long distance, then you're almost at Sothoris or Sothorius. But I guess not so many want to go here. It's a really dangerous place. We have the Basilisk Isles, for example, where there are a lot of pirates. I love toads, Skull Island. Not super friendly places. There is actually one island here where the inhabitants are really peaceful and friendly. That's not. South. The Indigo Straits, and then we have the island in the middle, Omburu. Some smaller islands here. So now we have the coast, the outlines of Essos, Satheros, Ultos, Summer Islands, and the islands around it. Guess I have forgot a lot of islands. There are so many of Greece. I said it was 300 islands here, and I have only drawn like 10, but yeah. Okay, I think it could be time for switch to a new color. And I think I'll go on with the reverse this time. So we start with this Rhône River. So all these branches, but the main river is called Rhône. This basin, the river basin, was a place for ancient kingdom, really rich civilization in the past. The Rhônar lived here. They used to live. Riches, Norvos, the mountains here, the Velvet Hills. I always think of rivers as starting with start. starting from the ocean and then like branches like this. But I guess it's the opposite. They start from the mountains, of course, and then they merge together. And ends up in the ocean, but I don't know. It's because it's much easier to draw them in this direction. Start with just one line and then just like a tree. And then we have another river system starting here at Morosh, close to Morosh. It's a river delta here. South to important city here. What's left of the old kingdom of Sarn. Painted mountains north of the Valyrian Peninsula. Here's also an interesting river and interesting lakes. Used to be a Silver Sea. Now it's turned into three smaller lakes somehow. So the sea used to be big like this, large lake, or large sea actually, inland sea. Here we have another river with a name that's hard to pronounce, at least to me. It's called the Skahazadan River. Basically the rivers I know about, but I guess there are rivers here as well. It's Ash River. And a river dividing Yiti with Shadowlands and there's also inland sea or lake called the Bleeding Sea, located here. There's also an interesting area, the western part of Yiti, called the Five Forts. There are five ancient forts built here, built from black stone material. This mysterious material that the entire city of Ashai is built of. absorb sunlight and make the city totally dark. Something like that, I'm not sure. I just read it. Or I saw it on the... Yeah, the information I get... where I get the information for... for these... I'm sorry, it's no river. Most of the information that I show you here on this map I got from the videos from YCreate. These are really good to learn about the basics of the geography of Västerås and Essos. Those are really good. It's like 10 minutes or so video for each part. Like Valeria is one part, one video, and the Keys is one video. Northern Essos has one video, and so on. But now I need to concentrate, so I won't make any... Well, like someone commented on my last video, there are no actual mistakes, there are just... salt water, this lake. That's why they call them Poison Sea, because their horses can't drink from it. Then they very much rely on their horses. Okay. I think it's time for mountain. Do you remember what color I used for mountains? I think yellow was for roads. Okay, this time I'll try this orange color for the mountains. Start with the Bone Mountain that goes right through the continent. Makes me think of the Ural Mountains actually, that divides Europe and Asia. This area makes me think of Europe and Asia and lost civilizations and old civilizations and empires. Like this could be the Mediterranean Sea and like Italy, Rome or Greece. Then east of the Bone Mountain, we have Asia with China and India, maybe. And, yeah. And here, of course, we have Iceland to bear north, Ibn. That's just how I think. It's not the painted mountains. of Norbos and the Velvet Hills here to the northwest of the continent. Where you can see all these branches of the Rhine River. Here, all the way to the free city of Braavos. That city was actually hidden for a very long time. It was like a secret city. Not easy to spot. These are mountainous regions. Valyria, what's left of Valyria, of course, has many mountains because this used to be 14 volcanoes. But those erupted at the same time. The tomb of Valyria destroyed the whole civilization, the whole city. Mountains here as well. And also between these mountains, something called the Kisai Pass, where you can reach the area of Lasar. The city of La Roche, here somewhere. And I can see on my map here that we have some mountains here as well. Makes sense with the river. And also here, by the Bay of Tusk. Also in the mountains of the Mourne. Yeah, like I said, I think of India here, and then we have huge mountainous area. The Shadowlands and the mountains of the Mourne. Like the Himalayas, of course. I guess it could have been the inspiration when creating this, at least this shape of the continent. And on Ib, there are quite a lot of mountains. Far Ib as well. Then we have some forests that I think should be green on this map. Do you think a lighter green or a darker green? Or maybe both, that would be nice. Like a little variation in the color. But I'll start with this. And in the kingdom of the Ifekebron, not sure if I pronounced this right, Ifekebron, place is almost completely forested area. Some believe that the woodwalkers that used to live here are still around here, and that they are like cousins or relatives to the children of the forest in Westeros. And Ib has some forest too. And Forest of Khor is the biggest forest here to the west. I guess the only forest. And on this peninsula that I don't know the name of actually, looks like there are some forest. I know there are giants living here, or at least historically, the Jokwin giant. And those were like in this world. Maybe we can do the forests to the south in this little lighter color. For some reason, I guess the vegetation is different in the north. Probably there are like fir trees and pine trees, and to the south there are like rainforest. Yeah, I think it's a big river system here in the rainforest. Could be nice to add. On the island of Leng, we have a lot of forest. Some great Morag. Actually, all these islands are green on the map I'm looking at, so I guess there are a lot of forests here. This is called the Cinnamon Straits that divides Great Morag and these islands and eventually Sotheby's. Mostly jungle, rainforest, really dangerous place, a lot of super dangerous animals. animals, cannibals, probably dangerous insects. And it looks like Utos, also quite forested. And also this area to the very northeast. I think it could be considered the easternmost known place on Lesbos. Mossobi. And yeah, not many have seen this place, but there are like rumors and myths about it, I guess. Are they here? They are like winged people, perhaps. Or maybe that was there's also a place called here called the City of the Winged Man. So. People can actually fly and have wings the more east you go on this continent. And the summer islands should also be green. And there's an area here that looks like a swamp or something. Can you use this lighter green color for that? So now we have the coast and the mountains and the rivers and the forest, the island. One thing that I find quite fascinating on this continent is the roads, the system of roads. Because when the Valyrian Freehold was when Valyria ruled most of this continent, at least west of the Bone Mountains, then they built this special system of roads. They were like elevated roads that they built completely straight between, for example, two important cities. So these are called the Valyrian Roads or the Dragon Roads, because they were built of stone, dragon fire. And these roads are actually, even though here I guess lots of them are ruins, but they're still here. So I would like to point out these. I just changed my mind because I think it will be easier to draw these cities first and then connect them with the roads, don't you think? Maybe we could zoom in a bit as well. So let's start here to the west. And here we have the so-called free cities. Braavos, I think I mentioned already. And Lorath. Let's see, Norvos should be here in the hills. And then we have Pentos by this bay here, small bay. And then we have this bay, and Tyros. I think you should say Tyros. It's on this little island just outside the coast. And then we have Lys, also on an island outside the coast. And this is called the Orange Coast, by the way. Next we have Volantis here, just where the river meets the sea. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. So there should be one more, and that's Kohor. The forest of Kohor. I think it's located here, approximately. One city that I find super interesting is a ruined city, and it's it was called Esaria, and that was considered to be the 10th of the free cities, I believe. So it was located here somewhere in these mountains. I think I can mark these ruined cities because there are actually a lot of them, like this, like a ring. And yeah, it was the free city that was located most to the east, and I guess that's the reason it was conquered and destroyed by the Dothraki during the Century of Blood, and then they renamed it Ves by Skadok. But it's no city anymore, it's just, it was left in ruins. Then we have the city, also very interesting city, I think, Saap, because it's the only remaining city from the kingdom of Sarnor, this huge kingdom here, this rich civilization, also destroyed by the Dothraki. didn't manage to ruin this city, so there are still these so-called tall men living here. And then we have Morosh. And it's actually a colony city of Lurath. So it's a fishing and mining colony. So it doesn't belong to the Dothraki either. And let's see what we have. Continue here along the north coast. Interesting city called the City of Ghosts by the Dothraki. I guess they avoid this place, so it's this area here, the kingdoms of the Ifekevron, or Ifekveron, a difficult name. It's actually not ruled by the Dothraki because it's, yeah, I guess they're afraid of this area actually, this forest. So they call this base Lacy, and it means City of Ghosts. I think it's considered like a haunted city or something, or ruins of a city. And then we have Ib and Iben, biggest city on Ib. It's port of Iben. I guess it's also the only city where foreigners are allowed to visit. Ibsar is a city on this little smaller island, far Ib. And this small peninsula here, the mainland, actually belongs to the Iben as well. Then there's a city or town called New Ibish. There's a ruined city, or where an old city used to be located, and that was Ibish, I guess old Ibish, now renamed by the Dothraki to, let's see, Baez Arasak, I think. And the only city in the Dothraki Sea is the vast Dothrak, located here. And east of the Bone Mountains, I guess there aren't so much to talk about. We have a city here called Nefer. Let's go on with the cities on the south coast and cities and former cities. The Dothraki Sea is a very vast area here in the middle, and since the only city is Baez Dothrak, then means there are a lot of ruined cities because they destroyed all the other cities and settlements. Mm. guess we have an old city, old Sarnor city called Sarnath. It would be located here somewhere. And the old Rhoynar civilization, there are also some abandoned or ruined cities. Nisar, this by this river, and Arnoy here, and the Soros should be located. Valyria, also there are some cities in ruins after the tomb of Valyria. So we have the city of Valyria. It's located here. And we have Tyra. No, sorry, Tyria. Located here. And Oros. There are actually some cities. It's Volantis, I already marked that. And there are Valisar, Valon, Theris, and Selhoris. And some cities in the former Valyrian peninsula that weren't destroyed. Mantaris, Illyria on a small island outside the coast, and Toldos. I know Toldos, the city is famed for its slingers that are built, that they construct there. We move on to the east. Then there are three important cities called the slaver cities. These were founded by the Kis, the old Kis empire, a very long time ago, and have a long history of slaves. So now it's called the Slaver Bay, the Slaver's Bay, and these are the three slaver cities. These are called Mirin here, by this river, Skahad, Sadan River, and Yunkai here, and Astapor. And Astapor, I know, famed for a very cruel army. Unsullied army. Then we have Gis, the old kingdom of Gis, this old civilization that ruled this continent many thousand years ago, before the Valyrians. They had their capital Gis located here, I think, but it was totally destroyed by the Valyrians about 5,000 years ago, and they actually salted this, the ground here, so then it's turned into a desert. Nothing can grow here anymore. But the descendants from the Giskari kingdom live on this area here, the slaver cities, and also founded a new city here on this small island called New Gis. And then we have this small country or kingdom in the mountains. I mentioned this Kisari Pass before, and it's how you can enter this La Roche area here. La Roche, so La Roche is the capital city, I guess, of Lazar. La Roche should be located here somewhere. And then we have some port cities here. It's a port Ios. And Carcash and Carth, just the Straits of Carth. And if we move further to the east, we have the Yiti, Golden Empire of the Yiti. This is a super old empire that used to be called the Great Empire of the Dawn, and they claim to be the first civilization in this area and the first cities, but there are many cultures that claim they were the first on Essos. But Yiti quite a lot of cities, and this Great Empire, they had they changed the capitals dependent on which emperor. When they change emperor, they often change the capital as well, but the current capital in Yiti is Yin, located just here. We have another city called Asabad. It's to the west of this empire. And Jinki, by this river. We have Tiki located here somewhere. And we have the trader town. It's quite important city, this area. I mentioned before the five forts. Those are located here. The Blackstone Forts. And there are actually quite a lot of cities on these islands as well. We have Ling Yi to the north here. We have Leng Ma, the center. We have Turani here to the south. And here we have to the very south tip of Great Morag, we have Port Morag. Faros on the western coast. And I forgot an island here, but it's a city on that one called Vahar. And the very mysterious, super large city of Ashai. They also claim to be the first city ever in the world. And then the Shadowlands. Very hostile place where there's only one known city, and that's Tigai here somewhere. And on Sotheros there are actually some places I find quite fascinating. It's a Gorosh, ruined city or abandoned city. These were actually colonies of the Empire of Keys a long time ago. They had actually two, I think, cities on Sotheros, and then also a city here called Yin. This was called Samatar. So Samatar, Yin, and Gorash. When Valyria conquered Keys, they didn't kept these cities in this hostile area. And so there aren't really any cities here known to the people outside. Still have to mark the cities here. We have Ebon Head, south of Jala Island, of the Summer Island. We have Tall Trees Town on this northern island, the Balano. No, sorry. Yeah, Balano Island. Zabad is a city located on this little island south of Great Morag. It's actually called Isle of Elephants. I think I also could mention a city here in the Bone Mountains and Howling Hills. Actually, just between the Bone Mountains and the Great Sand Sea, that's located here. Now let's see what this one is called. It's Kayakayanaya. Kayakayanaya. Let's see here. I forgot a quite important river on Sotheros. Don't know its name, but it has like a delta here. Just at this abandoned city, Zamatar, and it goes into the jungle like this. And also, where Jean was located. And, it's a long river all through Sotheros. Don't you think it looks a bit empty here between the forests and the mountains? I think you could mark out here's an interesting area called the Red Waste. Try to do a new type of symbol here, like small dashes. Makes sense, probably, for like grasslands, and this is more like a desert, I think. The Red Waste used to be like a fertile area where the Karth people lived. They actually originates from here somewhere in the former grasslands, but then the Dothraki here, and then they had to go move to the south, and then, but then this area was turned into the Red Desert, the Red Waste, and then so finally they moved to Karth, what's now Karth, here at the coast. But this is the Red Waste, really hostile. Here we have the Great Sand Sea. That's the gray waste. And then for the grasslands, I think I should have, could have green, but I mean I have green for the forests, maybe this lighter yellow. This apple green. Maybe I can have two colors. I've tried that. So somehow, yeah, I think this color was good actually. This was known as the grasslands, and some believe that the first men migrated to Westeros 12,000 years ago, that they actually originated from this area. And here, on the other side of the Bone Mountains, we have the plains of the Yogos Nahai, also plains like this. So in GT, north of the rainforest, I think there are some plains. And also here, to the very west of the continent, the disputed lands. The golden fields. The lands of the long summer. This looks quite nice. But I still want to try this. Maybe I can have this like a transition between mountains and plains. A bit messy, the look of this map. Maybe I could have. I have this green color that I like, it's like a forest green. Maybe I can use this for the forests and give it some more depth. Yeah, this was nice. Was a huge difference actually. So as well. And I think the last feature I would like to add on this map are some borders actually. It's not like in Westeros where there are like fixed borders for the old kingdoms, but I guess it could. I would like to somehow mark the area for the Dothraki Sea, because I think it's very central and it's great to see how vast it actually is. But I'm thinking about what type of color I would use. Some red. I think this one. No, okay, I haven't used this one. Start with the Dothraki Sea because I think it's easy to continue after that with the others, and I think it will be, or should I make it dotted? Yeah, I think so. Dothraki Sea is a huge area. So much coast actually. I think the Dothraki don't really like water. Perhaps. And it ends here. This was during the Central Blood, after the Tomb of Valyria. They came from east of these mountains, where their relatives, or some believe they are their relatives, the Yobos and High, also horse riding people, the raiders here, nomadic people of the east. But then they conquered like these civilizations were here before them, except some of them. So they did not show interest in the kingdom of the Ifekevron. They believed the city was haunted and all things like that. So they left some parts alone, and this is an actually small kingdom of its own. I guess they weren't conquered by the Dothraki. The Umber is called their kingdom. And I haven't read so much about it, I haven't found much information, but I guess they like pay some taxes or something, so for the Dothraki to leave them alone. And then we have this peninsula here, and like I said, we have the Sarnor, what's left of the Sarnor kingdom, and their capital Sarp. But also we have this very tip of the peninsula, the city Morash. Yeah, I mentioned that as well. That was the colony of Lorath. I think Lorath are basically on this island, but also on this coast here. And Braavos, westernmost area of Essos, and these are like independent cities called the Free Cities. They were part of the Valyrian Freehold, but they weren't actually ruled by Valyria. They had their own rulers. Then we have Pentos. Area around the city like this. I think it was actually nice to have this pale red color similar to the mountains, because I think they look quite nice together. We have Norvos there. I've seen a map where there's a little bit of coast here, belong to Norvos somehow. And the Axe Peninsula, where it's believed that the Andals originates from, these people that later moved here to what was called Andalus. But then 6,000 years ago migrated to even further west, to Westeros. Here we have Tyrosh, this island, and also I think a bit of the coast here, the mainland, and Myr, also an area around the city. These golden fields doesn't really belong to any kingdom or realm or anything. It's not like in Westeros, so there are many areas that aren't considered belong to some ruler, I guess. Lys on this island, and also the coast around it. Yeah. At the roads, of course. I will do that after these borders. Then we have Volantis, around the city of Volantis, and not sure if I can, like, Kiskari. Yeah, I think you could say Kiskari is some kind of independent area somehow, even though they don't live here on this, the old area where the old capital was. It's like, I think this can be considered the Kis. And Lasar as well could be considered some kind of kingdom. Karth, see. Let's see, this was the trader town, that's part of GT. And all the way to the five forts, and bordering the Shadowlands here to the east. It was like located east of this Bone Mountains. Mosovi, super mysterious area. I don't know if you can call it a kingdom. No, I don't think I should. I should draw in a border. Yeah, I think I said, did I mention this? Like there were winged people. I think that was wrong. That was actually the city of the winged men, where they were. Yeah, as you can hear, winged men. But I think there was something called the shape changers. I believe to live in this area, and no one really knows what that means. But you can imagine there are some strange people or hominids. There are a lot of I think you could call it's not like humans. I mean, there are different kind of creatures, hominids, human-like creatures, and they can't like interbreed with humans, so it's a lot of variety here in Essos. I think I'm done with the borders I wanted to have added on this map. And the last thing I would like to add are the roads. Because like I mentioned, there were these Valyrian roads made of dragon fire, actually stone and dragon fire, and these were completely straight and straight lines that connected the different cities. These special dragon roads or Valyrian roads, they are concentrated here to the west, what used to be the Valyrian Freyjord. So from Pentos also they have a road connecting Pentos and Norvus. Norms and Kohor and the ancient Roynar, city of Arnoy, and the ancient table. So this ancient city. And then it starts to be like an ordinary road with a lot of turns, and then you can take this road to Vice Jotrak. Those are the most interesting routes. Aren't these connected somewhere? That looks a bit odd, that there are like a system of roads here to the north and a system of roads here to the south. I think there were no bigger roads to these places. I think they have to go more with the boats here to reach these islands and these free cities. I mean, wouldn't, on the map I'm looking at here as a reference, I can't see any road from south to north. We have a short road here somewhere that goes a bit to the north, to this area, this river basin, and I guess like swamp, forest area. And then we have a road crossing the Bone Mountains. It's called the Steel Road. It goes through this city or town I mentioned before, the Kayanaya. And then it goes like this. The Great Sand Sea to Trader Town. Here there are no roads, at least I can't see any on my map. And here to Karth there are some roads as well. Coast here to the south and La Roche. And there's a road following the coast here, connecting Karth with Azabad. And also connecting major cities of Yiti. I guess the roads are quite small, it's a remote area, Great Sand Sea. But I think it's possible to go on roads like this. So I just wanted to be sure I made some connection between these two systems of roads. So this was what I could find at this point. So this is basically the map that I wanted to show you today. I think I forgot the border here. I just wanted to show that the Iben and Ib, I don't know if it's called Ib or Iben, but these islands, this archipelago, and also a bit of this coast. So this is basically the map of Essos that I wanted to show you today. A lot of different areas. Also parts of some other continents that we don't know so much about. Utos. So it was nice to draw this map and to learn all these things about this fantastic continent, a lot of stories, background stories about this continent. And thank you so much for requesting this map. It was requested by quite a few people. It was Hunger Games of Thrones, it was Blue in the Muse, it was Tacoman 172, Mark Esso, Clint F. Barton, C-O-205, Ryan Moran, Wartclaw, and Michael Gibbs, who requested this map. But I think there are some extra space here in the summer sea. This is the Shivering Sea. Here there are some space as well. This is a narrow sea that's between Essos and Westeros. We have also the Jade Sea here to the southeast. But I also got a request from S. Coleman and Kamala Marshall that you wanted to see a map including some sea monsters, and I thought, yeah, why not? I think it's room for that on this map, and also I think it would fit in quite well with the environment. There are a lot of strange creatures and monsters in this world, so why not try to draw a sea monster on this map? Nothing here could be spot for that. So start with some kind of feel. Can't do so much details using this. See what it's supposed to look. Found a lot of pictures of nice like sea monsters on medieval maps, ancient maps. Look really cool. And you can add some. Blurry to use this. This is my sea monster. So I guess I should try to do like a compass rose. Like when you do a sea monster, you almost expect to see a compass rose. So this is north, east, south, I hope you found this video relaxing. And sleep well. Thank you so much for watching my videos. Thank you to all new subscribers and old subscribers as well. Keep watching my videos. So fantastic to see. Motivates me a lot. Thank you. I'm finished with this map. I just realized I haven't written any names, but like I did with the Westeros one, I could write down some names on the for the seas surrounding it, I guess. It's nice to have at least some typography on a map, I think. It's gonna be a really long video, hope you don't mind. But we have, of course, the Shivering Sea to the north. And I think I'll write it like this. The And to the west we have the Narrow Sea. Dividing Essos from Westeros. To the south we have the Summer Sea. To the southeast, we have the Jade Sea. Saffron Straits. Here we have the Straits of Karth. And also, I would like to point out and label the Sin. Yeah, this was the saffron, so this is the cinnamon. Cinnamon Straits. And there we have it. relaxing.